Hi, I'm John from Fortified Estate. One of the questions that our team gets asked often is, what exactly is bulletproofing? So we're gonna go through that and also go through some of what the popular ballistic levels are. Bulletproofing is more accurately known as bullet resistance. Every material has a certain level of resistance to different types of bullets and what can go through. So true bullet resistance is being able to stop a bullet dead in its tracks. That's different from some window films or other type of products where it's called bullet resistant or even bulletproof, but the bullet goes right through, it just might not shatter. True bullet resistance is the bullet not even going through. Now, there's many different standards for bullet resistance around the world. One popular one that you might be familiar with if you're in law enforcement or just are interested in body armor is the NIJ system. That refers generally, however, to body armor resistance level. For doors, windows, and walls, the typical standard is actually the Underwriters Laboratory, and in specific, UL 752. UL 752 standard generally ranges from levels 1 to 8 of bullet resistance. It's generally considered the gold standard for that. Now, level 1 is for low-powered handguns, all the way up to level 8, which is for high-powered rifles. But you should note that it's not exactly in order. One interesting example is that level 6 is technically lower in strength than level 3. Each level just has to do with the number of bullets, the rounds, the caliber, and the speed. Now, you might be wondering, what ballistic level do you choose when there's so many options? Well, what we generally recommend is either at level 3, 7, or 8. Level 3, because it's the highest level for handguns on the list. In specific, that covers 44 magnums, and if you haven't had a chance to try one of those, I can tell you it's very powerful. Now, level 7 is popular because it's the lowest level available, but for rifles. So it's kind of the entry rifle level, if you will, and that's going to stop 5.56 caliber rounds. Finally, level 8 is popular for those who want the highest level of protection, and that's going to stop up to 7.62 rounds. But most of the weapons that you're going to see about in the news that are rifles generally fall under level 7. So it can be a great option to not be as costly as level 8 while still getting coverage for almost anything that you'd face. One thing I want to point out is that bullet resistance is not necessarily the most important security feature. Really, the most important is forced entry resistance in most cases. That's what's going to actually stop an attacker from gaining entry through door, window, or wall. But still, bullet resistance sometimes is very important. For example, in a panic room scenario, your family might be standing very close to the door. Therefore, even if a bullet isn't able to cause the door to open because it's forced entry resistant, since your family could be near the door, it's still, of course, critically important to have that ballistic protection. So with a lot of our clients, we generally go through their home or building and help them identify which areas we think bullet resistance is useful and where we think they can probably avoid that feature.